Hi, I'm Bob Impantino, Associate Dean for Undergraduate Education in the College of Computer, Mathematical, and Natural Sciences at the University of Maryland. Like you, I'm staying at home to help flatten the curve as I help our faculty members and students transition to online teaching and learning for the rest of this semester. I know you are dealing with lots of changes and challenges in your lives as well, and one big challenge is deciding where to go to college this fall, which is really hard when you can't come to visit our beautiful campus. To help you out, I'll be your virtual host today as we explore the amazing things our college has to offer. You'll also hear directly from our students about their individual experiences. So let's get started. The University of Maryland is a STEM university where students studying science and engineering fields comprise nearly half the student body. Our computer science and biological sciences majors are the two most popular majors on the entire campus, and we have a very diverse student population. We have more women in our computer science major than any other university in the country. 9% of our students are first-generation college students, and we are a national leader in graduating African-American undergraduates in STEM disciplines. Our 10 departments offer more than 23 different majors and specializations in math, computer science, the biological sciences, and the physical sciences. In addition, we offer 16 minors. Together, more than 7,500 undergraduates are pursuing majors and minors in the college. Our students are taught and mentored by more than 450 faculty members. We are a very student-focused college. Your journey will be guided by advisors to help you with your academic and career planning, from orientation to graduation. We're excited that this fall we will welcome our first freshman class into our new neuroscience major, building on the university's existing strengths in neuroscience research and graduate education. Our faculty members continue to explore new and exciting ways in which our academic programs can evolve to meet new opportunities. A multidisciplinary major in immersive media design will open to freshmen in the fall of 2021. And a new college-wide major in data science is currently under development. Our students learn and study in some beautiful spaces. Last spring, we opened the Brendan IRIBE Center for Computer Science and Engineering at the front door of our campus. For those of you planning to major in computer science, you'll be inspired by this amazing learning space. We also make extensive use of the Edward St. John Teaching and Learning Center, which opened 3 years ago and is home to brand new chemistry laboratories and state-of-the-art classrooms. We want you to take full advantage of the value added of studying at a research university. Our students use science to help understand and solve big problems. They are working on issues like climate change, human disease, and cybersecurity. And they are working with emerging technologies at the forefront of disciplines like genomics and health informatics, bioimaging, quantum computing, and virtual and augmented reality. Our students pursue research and internship opportunities that are unparalleled, seizing on the unfair advantage of our location. Students pursue their interests at the National Institutes of Health, NASA Goddard, the National Institutes of Standards and Technology, the Food and Drug Administration, the National Security Agency, the Smithsonian, in non-governmental organizations in healthcare, science advocacy, conservation, and many other fields, as well as at local companies. Student activities beyond the classroom are abundant, within the college and across campus. I'll share a few highlights. We welcome thousands of students from across the nation to our campus this year for four hackathons, including Technica, the largest female hackathon in the world. Students in Atmospheric and Oceanic Science launched and maintain weather.umd.edu, which broadcasts Maryland weather on the web, Facebook, and Twitter. Last fall, we offered our first broadcast meteorology course taught by a local on-air television meteorologist. Our math students placed 14th out of 488 teams in the 2019 Putnam Math Competition. Among more than 4,600 students who participated, senior Eric Metz ranked 51st. This past summer, a rocket carrying an experiment designed by five CMNS undergraduates to the International Space Station. Their project tested bacterial growth under different microgravity conditions. Since 2016, a large multidisciplinary team of students have designed, built, and competed in the SpaceX Hyperloop competition to build prototype transport pods capable of high-speed human transport. This year's team is shooting for speeds greater than 300 miles an hour. Our outstanding students are achievers in national and international contexts. In 2019, all four Maryland nominees for the National Goldwater Scholarship were winners. Over the last decade, Maryland's nominations have yielded 33 scholarships. That's the most in the nation, followed by Stanford with 29. Goldwater winners have gone on to win other prestigious international scholarships to support graduate study. Senior math and computer science major Tanae Walker was one of 15 Churchill scholarship winners this year. He will pursue his master's degree in advanced computer science at the University of Cambridge. Our 2015 Rhodes Scholar, Fang Cao, completed both a master's and a PhD at the University of Oxford and is now a second-year med student at Harvard University. The University of Maryland ranks 13th in the nation for undergraduates receiving National Science Foundation fellowships. Last year's recipients are enrolled in outstanding PhD programs at Harvard, the University of Michigan, Stanford, Princeton, UT Austin, UCLA, Johns Hopkins, and right here at Maryland. Three 2019 graduates were named Fulbright Scholars. A computer science graduate is now in Switzerland studying how to secure election systems. A biological sciences and Spanish language graduate is teaching in the Canary Islands. And a biological sciences graduate is teaching and working on healthcare education in Vietnam. We know that more than 92% of our 2019 graduates are pursuing further education or are employed 6 months out after graduation. 31% of our graduates are continuing their education, 55% are employed full-time, 6% part-time or in volunteer service, and the rest haven't told us. Many of our students pursue further study and careers in the health professions. For medical, dental, and graduate school acceptances, the most competitive admissions decisions are being made right now, so information is just beginning to trickle in. We know that at least 75 of our students have been admitted to the University of Maryland Medical School in Baltimore, and our students have also been admitted to Johns Hopkins, UCLA, Harvard, UC San Francisco, Stanford, and the other outstanding schools shown on this slide. For dental school, students have received acceptances to Harvard, UPenn, Columbia, and the University of Maryland, Baltimore. Overall, 67% of our students were admitted to MD programs in 2019, exceeding the national average by 26 percentage points. Our overall admit rate to dental school was 87%, exceeding the national average by 37 percentage points. Students interested in the health professions should visit the link at the end of this talk to view additional presentations on pre-med, pre-dent, and pre-allied health programs at the university. Our students work in a wide variety of federal agencies, small businesses, and Fortune 500 companies in the Maryland, D.C., Virginia region, across the country, and around the world. We are excited that Amazon chose to locate its second headquarters nearby in Crystal City, Virginia. This location is easily reachable by metro from our campus and will provide new internship and employment opportunities for our students. Our students also start companies. Anthony Casalena, a 2004 alum, started the web design and web hosting company called Squarespace in his dorm room. Its most recent valuation was $1.7 billion. Clay Segal, class of 1982, was inspired to find new cancer therapies after his father was stricken with the disease. He founded Seattle Genetics, which has developed a successful pipeline of cancer therapies that are changing lives. And last but not least, Brendan IRIBE, Michael Antonov, and Andrew Reese. They met in Maryland's dorms and became serial entrepreneurs, selling their first gaming company for $3 million. They sold their second one to Sony for $300 million, and their next venture, which you may have heard of, the virtual reality company Oculus, was sold to Facebook for $2 billion. They have shared generously with us by making major investments in our new computer science building, funding scholarships, and by supporting initiatives in diversity and inclusion in computing. Our alumni are some of the most dedicated champions of our current student success, and generously support them through mentorship, internship, and professional networking opportunities and scholarships. From the DMV to New York to the Silicon Valley and around the globe, there are more than 45,000 CMNS alumni who want to help you to succeed. Now, this might not seem like you yet. Our students are working to discover new knowledge and to improve the lives of others. They repeatedly tell me, "Maryland transformed me." But don't take my word for it. Hear it straight from some of our students. They wish they could meet you in person, but since they're at home across the country, they recorded messages just for you about their experiences here at Maryland.
The decision to go to UMD was pretty easy for me. It made sense geographically, both as an astronomy and physics major and just as a general STEM major. There's tons of opportunities, whether that be at NASA or another government agency or any other research agency nearby.
I know that computer science at Maryland is top 10 in the nation, and so that was a really big push for me to come here.
I checked all the boxes I wanted. It was a big school, had a great, beautiful campus feel, close to a city, obviously has a very good STEM program, and the professors really care about their students.
As an out-of-state student, I came on a campus not knowing anybody, but I found that it was pretty easy to make friends, both through living in the dorms my freshman year. I made a lot of friends just by the people that I interacted with every day.
Just simply saying hi to someone opens up so many doors. In fact, in my first class of college, I ended up meeting two of my closest friends, and because of them, I was introduced to so many great organizations on campus, where I've met so many people with such diverse backgrounds.
The school doesn't really feel impersonal because right away you're living with other people who are in the exact same boat as you. It's not like you're the only new kid. No one really knows anyone.
I think the best way to make a big school seem small is to be involved in student orgs or your department or whatever other opportunities you have.
College is really fun because you learn a lot of different things about yourself. You learn about how you work in different relationships, but with your teachers and your friends and things like that. But for me, I think the biggest thing I learned is how to be independent.
Time management is key to everything, balancing academics, extracurriculars, work, other things like that. You definitely have to learn time management and your time management skills. I learned it through just experience.
For my toughest classes, I think the most important thing was to not fall behind on my studying. So I really tried to stick to a schedule of like what I was going to study every day and then actually be proactive about committing to the schedule.
In my experience, professors are pretty accessible and approachable, whether I'm asking content related question about career advice or sometimes just even to chat. They're really there for you and willing to help.
No one likes to admit that they're doing bad in a class, but CMNS made it so easy. There's like a list of tutors for these super hard classes that are TAs doing it part-time on the CMNS website because they know how difficult it is, and I had a lot of support and ended up being very successful.
One of the coolest experiences I've had as a UMD student was being able to lead an alternative breaks experience to Port-au-Prince, Haiti, where we engage in service learning. So not only are we learning about community development in that case after disaster, but also being able to serve, and we taught English with local community organizations.
The coolest thing I've been a part of at UMD is student-initiated courses, or STICs, and I started out in fall 2018 as a student facilitator for a course that I designed called Mathematics and Classical Music in the math department.
All science majors can study abroad, so I did two winter abroads, one my sophomore year to Sydney, Australia for 3 weeks, and then one in January to Singapore, Malaysia, Vietnam, and Thailand.
There's a little bit of everything for everyone here, and I found my places at UMD.
I would describe Maryland students as diverse, driven, and passionate.
I think that we're all extremely passionate about our school and really proud to be able to say that we're TERPS, and this is something that you can feel all the time, whether you're at like a sporting event or at Maryland Day. Everyone is just so proud to be wearing their red, black, and gold.
I feel like everyone has interests outside their major and are really passionate about the work that they do, not only to get their degree, but also their side hobbies as well.
Having a student body that is passionate and driven and doing things outside of class, I think really kind of lit a flame within me in order to also kind of pursue those kinds of things and see those things are kind of possible.
We are all TERPS. We love going to soccer games, basketball games, football games. Like Maryland Day, there are so many different activities where you can show your pride. And most importantly, go TERPS!
We want you to have all the information you need to choose the best college for you. Visit our virtual folder for more information about each of our majors. Our coordinator of undergraduate admissions and recruitment, Eden Garosi, is also available to answer any questions you might have. We want you to join our rich and diverse community. Our college has trained a Nobel Prize winner, two congressmen, several university presidents, distinguished leaders in scientific research, CEOs and entrepreneurs, the founder of Google, and thousands of physicians, dentists, lawyers, and science-literate citizens. And you could be next. We hope you will join us as a science TERP in the fall. Go TERPS!